गवर्नर ऑफ ओडिशा श्री रघुबर दास जी, चीफ मिनिस्टर श्री मोहन चरण मांझी जी, यूनियन मिनिस्टर ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स श्री जुएल ओराम जी, रक्षा राज्य मंत्री श्री संजय सेठ जी, चीफ ऑफ द नेवल स्टाफ एडमिरल दिनेश के त्रिपाठी जी, डेप्यूटी चीफ मिनिस्टर्स श्री कनकवर्धन सिंहदेव जी एंड श्रीमती प्रभाती परिडा जी, स्पीकर ओडिशा लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली श्री सुरमा पाढ़ी जी, श्रीमती रेमा पाढ़ी जी, चीफ जस्टिस हाईकोर्ट ऑफ ओडिशा श्री जस्टिस चक्रधारी शरण सिंह जी, फ्लैग ऑफिसर कमांडिंग इन चीफ ईस्टर्न नेवल कमांड वाइस एडमिरल राजेश पेंडारकर जी, डिस्टिंग्विश्ड गेस्ट, फ्लैग ऑफिसर्स ऑफिसर्स सेलर्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, आई एम ग्लैड टू बी हियर एट पुरी टू विटनेस द ऑपरेशनल डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन कंडक्टेड बाय द इंडियन नेवी. लेट मी बिगिन बाय ऑफरिंग माय ग्रीटिंग्स टू यू एंड ऑल पर्सनल ऑफ द इंडियन नेवी ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ नेवी डे. टुडे ऑन द 4th ऑफ डिसेंबर वी सेलिब्रेट आवर ग्लोरियस विक्ट्री इन द 1979 वॉर एंड कोमेमोरेट द सेल्फलेस सर्विस एंड सुप्रीम सैक्रिफाइस मेड बाय नेवल पर्सनल इन डिफेंस ऑफ द मदरलैंड. I would also like to recall the sacrifice and courage of Captain Mahendra Nath Mula, a brave naval officer who demonstrated exceptional valor and leadership during the 1971 Indo-Pak War. As the commanding officer of INS Phukri, he played a crucial role in several key operations and eventually laid down his life. Recently, I had the opportunity to pay homage to him during my visit to Diu. India is grateful to you, and every Indian salutes you for serving the nation with honor and courage. As your Supreme Commander, I am proud of each one of you for your professionalism, passion, and patriotism, which was on display here moments ago. I must compliment you for a well coordinated and well conducted operational demonstration that has given a glimpse to our fellow citizens of how our Navy operates at sea. I consider myself fortunate to have interacted with you all closely over the last 2 years. On every such occasion, as is the case today, I have felt reassured of the security of our seas. Ladies and gentlemen, India's geography has endowed us with all elements necessary to be a great maritime nation. A long coastline, island territories, seafaring population, and developed maritime infrastructure encouraged India's maritime activities along the coast and across the oceans from more than 5,000 years ago. We were among the pioneers in the oceanic transport. Our shipbuilding prowess and ability to harness the monsoon wind patterns enabled us to dominate the seaborne trade. With a glorious maritime heritage and history to look back upon and a future full of promise to look forward to, India has always been a strong maritime nation, our fortunes, glory, and identity being defined by the sea. As India's economy grows and our interest and influence expand across the globe, I am confident that the Indian Navy will continue to ensure maritime security essential to enable our rise to a Viksit Bharat by 2047. I compliment the Navy for choosing the city of Puri as the venue for 2 days' events. Puri's rich maritime past is linked to the ancient territorial subdivision of Kalinga, which included much of the present-day Odisha. Ancient Kalinga had vibrant maritime linkages and extensive shipbuilding activities to supplement the flourishing trade. That glorious past is going to be reflected into the future that is taking shape here in Odisha at INS Chilika, where young boys and girls from across the country trained to become Agniveers in the service of the Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, over the last year, the Navy has been at the forefront of all operational activities in the region, ensuring safety of seafarers and security of maritime trade, providing humanitarian assistance and disaster relief with threatening illegal drug trafficking at sea that funds terrorist activities that endanger our national security. The seamless integration of advanced technology, tactical acumen, and sheer courage on display today aptly showcase the evolution of our Navy into a combat-ready, future-ready, and credible force. With 63 ships being built in India, the Navy's single-minded focus to be an Atmanirbhar force by 2047 provides inspiration to all of us to pursue innovation and mission mode. It is a matter of pride for every Indian that we are today one of only 6 nations in the world that have the capability to design, build, and operate both a ballistic missile nuclear submarine and an aircraft carrier. The Navy's pioneering efforts in providing appropriate growth avenues to Nari Shakti are especially praiseworthy. The Navy was the first service to induct women Agniveers and continues to ensure that all ranks and all roles, including combat functions, are available to all women. In fact, 2 women naval officers, Lieutenant Commander Dilnake and Lieutenant Commander Rupa, provide the best example of this new paradigm as they circumnavigate the globe in INSV Tarini as part of the Navika Sagar Parikrama 2. I compliment the Indian Navy for the successful conduct of today's event and for their drive, determination, and dedication to duty. I wish the Indian Navy the very best for all future endeavors. Song no Baruno, may the God of the oceans be auspicious unto us. May the Indian Navy always be victorious. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.